Watch, Trump meets with Japan's emperor, humiliates Obama with first thing he did there. President Donald Trump recently traveled to Japan to meet with their leaders and discuss things of importance to our countries, but it's not his agenda that has everyone talking. As it turns out, the president met with the nation's emperor, where he did something that had to leave Barack Obama downright frustrated, and Trump made sure it was the very first thing he did. Trump left Sunday to head for Japan to talk about a wide range of topics from trade to even how to best deal with North Korea. However, while he was there, he made sure to dish out quite the slight dig toward his predecessor, and it was so subtle that many people actually missed it. When Trump met with Japan's emperor, things wouldn't go like the last time the foreign official met the president of the United States and leader of the free world. As it turns out, the current president made sure that the first thing he did was paint America as the superpower that it is. For those unaware, the Department of State urges presidents and diplomats to acknowledge and follow local customs as a sign of respect. With that being said, it doesn't, however, suggest that presidents bow to other officials, as that is actually a sign of submission. Of course, former President Barack Obama apparently didn't get the message, as he made sure that he bowed the bow of all ages when he first met the emperor. Not only was the bow over the top, but he bowed so low that it didn't even really coincide with what is expected in Japanese culture. As one would imagine, the American people criticized Obama for quite some time as it made him, and us, look weak on the world stage. Some even went so far to joke around, saying that Obama's weak spine merely gave out at the wrong time after fighting to stay erect for so long. Either way, there's no arguing that it didn't look good, the leader of the free world bowing to someone else. Fortunately, it looks like that is a thing of the past, at least, for now, as Trump wasn't about to let that happen. Clearly seen in video footage of the exchange since shared by BizPak Review, Trump opted for a simple handshake rather than a bow of submission. Even better yet, the greeting went off without a hitch and not a single person complained, unlike with what happened when the limp-wristed Obama tried to show off in front of the world. America is supposed to be an example for the rest of the globe. We stand for things that many other people around the world don't get to enjoy, and that's freedom, equality, and human rights. Our leaders are elected, not put into position by birthright, and we certainly don't bow down in submission to them. At the end of the day, we all have the same rights and we all deserve the same respect, it's as simple as that. As for the culture of other countries, well, they're free to do whatever they want, but that doesn't mean we have to agree with it or subject ourselves to it. President Donald Trump undoubtedly did the right thing here by not submitting to cultural practices like Obama. After all, there's nothing worse than being the leader of the free world and having your picture taken as you're bent over, metaphorically ready to take it up the rear in the name of political correctness and tolerance. That's not a good look on anyone.